Hello students, I welcome you all in the e-learning classes of physics, and in today's video we are going to discuss about the combination of cells. So like the combinations of resistors and capacitors, combination of cells is also can be categorized into two category: series combination and parallel combination. So we will discuss one by one series combination and thereafter parallel combination. But before going into detail discussion of this topic, first I would like to make you understand that what is the need of combining the cells, or what is the need of combination of cells. So let us have a simple example. Suppose I am having any electronic device, suppose radio, and this radio require at least you know 1 ampere current to be operated. So we are connecting this radio with the help of a cell which or whose ability is only to deliver up to 0.5 ampere. So will this radio work? You will say definitely no. So if you want to operate this radio with the help of battery, then definitely we need to apply more cells, more battery for making, you know, proper supply of current to this radio. So if we combine two such type of cells in series, here in particular case, then definitely they both will supply 1 ampere current in total, and this radio will operate successfully, or you can say satisfactorily. So to combine the cells, the basic purpose behind combination of cell is to maximize the current, to maximize the current in a load. So if you want to maximize the current through the load, we need to combine the cells. Now, will the cells be combined in series or will the cells be combined in parallel? This will totally depend upon the load which is to be driven by those cells. So we will discuss it later, that when we apply series combination and when we will prefer parallel combinations. But for the time being, you must know that what is the purpose behind combination of cells, and your answer will be to maximize the value of load current. Okay, now let us discuss what are the various types of combination of cells. So as you know that like, you know, combinations of resistors and capacitors, combination of cells is basically of two types: series combination and parallel combination. So we will discuss one by one. First, we are going to discuss series combination of cells. Series combination of cells. So suppose we are having one cell whose EMF is E1 and internal resistance is small R1. And another cell whose EMF is E2 and internal resistance is R2. What is EMF? What is internal resistance? We have already discussed in our previous lecture. So I hope you must have gone through that lecture. So we want to combine these two cells in series. So definitely the combined circuit will be E1, R1. And one thing more you need to you know, memorize is that this internal resistance is always in series of the battery. So and if it is represented by small r, then definitely it is internal resistance, and if it is represented by capital R, then that is external resistance. So here in this chapter we will describe, you know, some resistances by small r, some resistances by capital R. So capital R means external resistance or load resistance which is to be driven by this cells, and a small r resistance is the internal resistances of these cells. So an internal resistance is always connected in the series of a cell.
load resistance may be in parallel or series, that will depend on the circuitry. So these two cells we want to connect in series. So this is first cell and this is second cell, whose EMF is E2 and internal resistance is R2. And with the help of this combination, suppose we want to supply the load current to this external resistance named as capital R. So this is the load that we want to derive or drive with the help of these two cells, which is in series. So basically what we want to do here in this topic, we will, you know, find the equivalent EMF of these two cells. Suppose we want to connect a single cell which will supply the same current in case of, you know, or this combination. So we want to derive the formula of equivalent EMF and equivalent resistance, internal resistance in fact, in case of series combination. So what we will do, we will apply KVL. And what is KVL, how it is applied in a circuit, and how it is very helpful or handy in solving the circuits, we have already discussed in our last lecture, which was numerical problems on KCL and KVL. So here I will apply KVL, and the direction of KVL I am assuming is suppose clockwise. So this is your choice, you can assume clockwise as well as anti-clockwise. And suppose the direction of current is here from positive to negative, or you may also assume the direction of current as clockwise. So suppose high current is flowing through this load, so can you find out the value of high? Definitely using KVL. So applying KVL in this loop, suppose we are starting from here, this is positive, this is negative, this is positive and this is negative. So since all are in series, definitely current will same across all the resistances. So applying KVL in this loop and starting from this point, since positive terminal of the battery coming first, therefore the EMF of this cell will be written as positive. So this is E1. Now the current, you know, flowing in anti-clockwise direction or in this direction, and the direction of KVL is this in this direction, therefore the voltage drop will be negative. So it will be I into R, that is I into small R1. Okay, now the EMF of this battery will be written as plus E2 as per the sign convention we have already discussed. And in this also, the voltage drop will be negative, that is minus I into R2. And now, across this load resistance, current is flowing in this direction and we are moving in this direction. So voltage drop across this resistance will also be negative, that is I into R. And the total potential difference across a loop, according to KVL, is always equals to zero. So we have put it equal to zero. Now, E1 minus, if I take common from these three terms, from this and from this. So it can be written as R1 plus R2 plus R and plus E2 is equal to zero. And if I, you know, take this term here or these terms here, so I can write it I into R1 plus R2 plus capital R is equal to E1 plus E2. And I want to find the value of current, that is I is equal to E1 plus E2 upon R plus R1 plus R2. Now, if I put E1 plus E2 as E equivalent EMF of these two cells and R1 plus R2 as equivalent of internal resistance, then the expression comes out to be I is equal to E equivalent upon R plus R equivalent. And now you can say that if I use the battery of equivalent EMF and small R equivalent internal resistance, then the value of current supplied by this combination will be same as that in this case. So from here I can write down that where
where E equivalent is equal to E1 plus E2 and R equivalent is equal to R1 plus R2. And for N cells, this discussion is for two cells in series, but this can be extended up to N cells. So for N cells in series, what can be written? For N cells in series, E equivalent can be written as E1 plus E2 plus E3 and so on up to En. And similarly, R equivalent will become R1 plus R2 plus R3 and so on up to Rn. So these formula we can use for series combination of N cells. So this is how we can derive the formula of current flowing through the series combination of resistances. This formula you should keep in mind for numerical purpose. And this is the expression which we want to derive, the equivalent EMF in case of N cells in series and the equivalent resistance, internal resistance in fact, in N cells in series. So now we will discuss that what happen if we combine N identical cells in series and where the series combination should be actually used, or what should be the value of, you know, external resistance. It should be lower or it should be higher. So we will discuss it later. You can note it down. So now we will discuss the special case of series combination. Suppose we are having N identical cells connected in series. So what will be the equivalent EMF and what will be the equivalent resistance, and where such type of combination should be deployed? So we will discuss it. Suppose we are having N identical cell, as we have already suppose. So equivalent EMF, we will use the formula of equivalent EMF in case of N cells in series. Equivalent EMF, we have derived the formula E1 plus E2 plus E3 and so on up to En. But as given that these cells are identical cells, so therefore the EMF and internal resistances of all the cells will be equal. So E1 is equal to E2 is equal to En. And suppose the value of equal EMF is E, suppose. We can assume this, suppose. Okay. Now putting the value of E1, E2, E3 as E in this equation, suppose this is equation first. So what will be the value of E equivalent? So E equivalent becomes N times E. E plus E plus E, N times E. So we can write down E equivalent as N times E. So this is equation, suppose, second. Similarly, we can write down the equivalent resistance, because equivalent resistance in series combination R1 plus R2 plus R3 and so on up to Rn. And since it is given that these cells are identical, therefore R1 is equal to R2 plus R3 is equal to Rn, and suppose this is equals to R. So this becomes R equivalent is equal to N times R, and this is the suppose equation third. Now using this formula, current I is equal to E equivalent upon R plus R equivalent in case of series combination. If I put the value of E equivalent as N times E and R equivalent as N times R, so the expression of current comes out to be N times E upon R plus N R. And now I want to maximize the value of current. So I am putting the condition here that if R is very, very greater than NR, means the internal resistance of all the cells connected in series is very, very less than the external load resistance, or the value of load resistance suppose is very high. So here I can write down, or I can use this condition, that R plus NR can be approximately equal to R.
If the value of NR is very low, less as compared to the value of load resistance, then definitely the sum will be approximately equal to capital R. And from here, I can write down I is equal to NE upon capital R. And this you can understand that due to one cell, the current is E upon R across load. And the current becomes N times due to N cells. So this is why, or that is why we prefer series combination when this condition actually occurs. The value of load resistance is very, very high as compared to the total internal resistance of the cells. So if the value of load resistance is very high, the current becomes N times to the current when we are using a single cell. And what was the purpose behind combination of cells? So you will say to maximize the value of current. So here we are obtaining N times of current by simply using or by simply connecting N cells in series. So I hope you can make a point here that the series combination will always be beneficial whenever we are having this condition that the load resistance is very high as compared to the internal resistance. Let us look, have a look on, you know, the reverse case also. Suppose R is very, very less than small r, or small nr is greater than capital R. So here I can write R plus nr as nr, and simply put this value here. So we will having NE upon NR, and this N will be cancelled out by this N. So E upon R, and E upon R is the total current flowing through the circuit, which is equal to the one current supplied by one cell. So what is the purpose behind using N types of cell? So it will become very costly as well as, you know, less efficient, I can say, if N cells are supplying equal amount of current that is, you know, supplied by one cell. So what is the purpose behind using combination of cell? So that is why we prefer series combination when capital R or load resistance is very, very greater than the total internal resistance of the series combination. So this is about series combination. Now we will discuss about parallel combination of cells, which is very, very important so far as CBSE exam is concerned. So it is frequently asked in CBSE. So we will discuss it later. So now we will discuss the parallel combination of cells. So we are having, suppose, two cells, EMF E1 and internal resistance R1. This is first cell, and another cell is whose EMF is E2 and internal resistance is R2. And suppose these are in parallel combination, and this parallel combination is basically used to drive this external load resistance capital R, through which we have to maximize the load current I. So suppose I current is flowing in this direction, and definitely this I current will be divided into two parts or supplied by these two batteries. So suppose this branch of, you know, this branch is supplying I1 current, and this branch is supplying I2 current, in fact. But I2 can be written as, since I current is entering at this point, so we can apply KCL here, and this will divide it into two parts. Some part of the current will go into this branch. Suppose this is I1. So how much left? You will say I minus I1. So we will use I minus I1 instead of I2 here in this branch. And this is positive terminal, and this is negative, this is positive negative of A2. So this is the diagram of parallel combination of two cells, and this topic is frequently asked in CBSE exams. So you need to focus on this particular topic. Okay, so in the similar fashion as we have you know, derive the formula of you know, equivalent EMF and equivalent resistance in series combination by simply using KVL. Here also we will use KVL, but here we will use KVL in two loops. So first loop will be, suppose I am denoting it by A, suppose this point is denoted by A, or this branch is denoted by AB, in which even or first cell is connected, and this branch is represented by suppose CD, and suppose this part is, you know, CDEF. So there are two loops, you can see from the diagram. One loop is ABEFA, and second loop is, you know, CDEF. So we will apply KVL in these two loops. We will having two equations, and we will solve out those equations to find the value of current, and thereafter we will find the equivalent EMF of this combination and equivalent resistance of this combination. So applying KVL in loop first, or you can say A B, this loop is suppose or will be EF, AB, EF, and once again we are reaching at A. So suppose we are starting from here, the direction of current is same as the direction of KVL, because we are moving like this. So the direction of current and KVL is same. So according to sign convention, the voltage drop will be positive. So I am writing here I1 R1, and since negative terminal coming first, so EMF will be minus E1, and thereafter we will reach at this point. So the direction of current and the direction of KVL is same, therefore it will represent represented by positive IR, or voltage drop will be positive. So this is suppose equation first. Similarly, we can apply KVL in loop second, or this loop second is denoted by CDEFC. So this will be written as, suppose we are starting from here, so the voltage drop will be positive since the direction of KVL and the direction of current is same. We are moving in this loop like this, clockwise direction, anti-clockwise direction, sorry. So the direction of current flowing through this loop and KVL is same, so voltage drop will be positive. So it will be I minus I1, since I2 is represented by I minus I1 using KCL at point this. So I minus I1 into R2 minus E2, and the voltage drop will be positive across load resistance R, I into R, and this is suppose equation second. Now what we have to do, we will multiply this equation by R2, small R2, and we will multiply this equation second by small R1, and thereafter we will add these equations. So we will be having very helpful relation. With the help of that, we can derive the equivalent formula of equivalent EMF. So what we have to do, I am multiplying equation first, multiplying equation first by R2, which is the internal resistance of second battery. For first loop, we will multiply the internal resistance of second loop, and for second loop, we will multiply the internal resistance of first loop or first battery, we can say. So this we are getting I1 R1 R2 minus E1 R1, sorry, R1 R2, sorry, R2 say मल्टीप्लाई किया है यहाँ पे हमने E1 R2 प्लस IR R2. सो दिस इज और दिस इज इक्वल टू जीरो, दिस इज इक्वेशन थर्ड. सिमिलरली वी विल मल्टीप्लाई दिस इक्वेशन बाय यू नो R1. सो वी आर हैविंग I माइनस I1
R1 R2 minus E2 R1 plus I R into R1 and equals to 0. This is equation 4. Now what we have to do, we will actually add up these two equations. So simply adding these two equations, on adding equation 3rd and equation 4, what can be written here? You can easily understand that this I1 R1 R2 is positive and minus I1 R1 R2, this is negative. So if we add these two equations, we are adding these two equations, so this will cancel out this. Okay, now IR R2 and this is IR R1, so we will take IR as common from these two, so we will be having R1 plus R2. Okay, and E1 R2, this is negative. E2 R1, this is also negative, so we can take it on right side. So these two terms will become positive. So I hope this you have understood. So how can be written? I into R1 R2. Now adding these two, this has been cancelled out with the help of this. This is positive term, this is negative term, already discussed. Minus E1 R2 minus E2 R1. Or here we can take IR as common from both the terms. So this will come out to be R1 plus R2. And this would be equal to 0 if you don't take this right side. Now we can take it right side, so, and take I as common from these terms, from here as well as from here. So if you take I as common, so it will come out to be R1 plus R2 plus R1, or in fact R is also there, so we will write as R1 R2 plus R, R1 plus R2. We are taking I common from this and this term. Okay, now E1 R2, this equals to E1 R2 plus E2 R1. And since we have to find out the value of load current flowing through this load resistance due to the combination of these two cells in parallel, so I can be written as I is equal to E1 R2 plus E2 R1 divided by R1 R2 plus R R1 plus R2. So this is the expression we have obtained from this all this discussion, or using KVL in these two loops. Now we need to write this equation in terms of equivalent EMF and equivalent internal resistance. So some more steps we have to involve for simplification of this equation. What we will do, we will divide the numerator and denominator by R1 plus R2, this term. So dividing R1 dividing numerator and denominator, numerator and denominator by R1 plus R2. So if you divide this numerator here by R1 plus R2, then we can write down E1 R2 plus E2 R1, this is divided by R1 plus R2. Okay, now talk about this denominator. So this will be divided by R1 plus R2, so it will become R1 R2 upon R1 plus R2, and simply dividing by this term by R1 plus R2, so it will cancel out, so it is written as simply capital R. Okay, now we will write this term as equivalent EMF, E equivalent, divided by this term R1 R2 upon R1 plus R2, small r equivalent, and this is capital R. So this is the expression of current flowing through the load.
and where E equivalent we have written in place of E1 R2 plus E2 R1 divided by R1 plus R2. Okay, and R equivalent we have written in place of this term, that is R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2. So these are the two formulas of equivalent EMF and equivalent internal resistance of the two cells connected in parallel combination. So if it is asked that derive the formula of equivalent EMF and equivalent internal resistance of the parallel combinations of two cells, then definitely you need to derive up to this. And suppose this is equation fifth and this is equation suppose sixth, or suppose this is equation fifth, you need to know or recall this equation. It will be used in numerical. And this is suppose equation sixth and this is equation suppose seven. Okay, so this is the equivalent EMF of two batteries, two cells connected in series, and this is the equivalent internal resistance of the two cells connected in parallel. But what if we want to connect n cells in parallel? So can we expand extend these two equations for n cells, as in case of series? It was very easy to write down E equivalent and R equivalent for n cells in series, but here you can see that it is very difficult to write down the E equivalent and R equivalent in for n cells in parallel. But we will derive some way how to write E equivalent and R equivalent in case of n cells in parallel. So you can note it down up to here, and we will definitely we are going to write these expressions for n cells also. So you can note it down. Okay, so for writing these two equations for n cells, what we will do, we will divide equation 6 by equation 7. So dividing equation 6, although the formula has already been derived for the two cells, but what we want to do, we want to extend this formula for n cells in parallel. So if in exam it is asked that derive the formula for two cells in parallel combination, so you have to solve up to this. But for n cells, what should be done? So we are moving on to that topic. So dividing equation sixth by seven, by equation seven. So E equivalent upon R equivalent is equal to E1 R2 plus E2 R1 divided by R1 plus R2 divided by R equivalent, that is R1 R2 upon R1 plus R2. So this R1 plus R2 will be cancelled out by this R1 plus R2. So we are having E1 R2 plus E2 R1 divided by R1 R2. And now you can write down here that if I separate these two terms, E1 R2 divided by R1 R2 and E2 R1 divided by R1 R2. So what can be written? This R2 will be cancelled out with this R2. So it will be written as E1 upon R1. Similarly, this R1 will be cancelled out with this R1. So E2 divided by R2. So this is E equivalent upon R equivalent. So this is the formula for two cells in parallel. But now you can have the idea. you are getting the idea that how this expression can be expanded for n cells. So for n cells, what can be written? For n cells, E equivalent upon R equivalent is equal to E1 upon R1 plus E2 upon R2 plus E3 upon R3 and so on up to En upon Rn. So this is how these formulas can be extended for n cells. But we cannot have the, you know, separate equation or individual equation for E equivalent. It is the equation of E equivalent upon R equivalent. So this is for n cells. And can you write now the equation for R equivalent? So this R equivalent can be written as, since R equivalent we are having as R1 upon R2 plus, sorry, R1 R2 upon R1 plus R2. So this can be written as 1 upon R equivalent is equal to 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2. So this is the expression for two cells. Can this expression be extended for n cells? Yes. 1 upon, for n cells, I am writing here, for n cells in parallel, 1 upon R equivalent is equal to 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2 plus 1 upon R3 and so on up to 1 upon Rn. So this is how we can extend these two formulas, the two equations, which originally derived for two cells in parallel, for n cells in parallel. So this is all about this derivation. Now we will focus on the special case, which is what happen if n identical cells are connected in parallel, then what is the expression for E equivalent and R equivalent. So you can note it down for a while. So now we will discuss the special case for parallel combination of cells. And suppose we are having n identical cells connected in parallel. So we have already derived these expressions for n identical, n cells in parallel. E equivalent upon R equivalent is equal to this, and 1 upon R equivalent is equal to this. So if the cells are identical, then definitely their EMF will be same. So suppose these all are equal and we have taken as E, EMF of all the cells. Similarly, we have taken R1 is equal to R2 is equal to Rn is equal to R. Okay, since these are identical cells, so we can write their EMF and equivalent, internal resistance is equal. So from this equation, what can be written? E equivalent upon R equivalent is equal to E1 upon R1, we can put E upon R, plus E upon R, plus E upon R, and so on up to E upon R. And this can be written as N times E upon R. So this is E equivalent upon R equivalent. Okay. Now, putting the value of R equivalent, you know, or 1 upon R equivalent. So from here, what can be written? 1 upon R equivalent is equal to 1 upon R plus 1 upon R plus 1 upon R and so on up to 1 upon R n times. So this can be written as R equivalent is equal to n times 1 upon R, or R equivalent is R by n. So R equivalent we have obtained as R by n. Suppose this is equation third. And E equivalent upon R equivalent as n times E upon R, that is equation 4. So simply putting the value of R equivalent in this equation, we can have the value of E equivalent. So E equivalent can be written as n E upon R multiplied by R equivalent. Now n times E upon R multiplied by R equivalent, that is R by N. So R is cancelled out by this small r, and N is also cancelled out by this N. So E equivalent comes out to be E. So in case of identical N cells connected in parallel, the equivalent EMF is same as that of the EMF of one cell. Now the equivalent resistance is definitely 1 by n times the internal resistance of a single cell. So these are R equivalent and E equivalent in case of identical cells. Now we will use these two equations. This is equation suppose 5 for finding the value of current. So the expression for current was I is equal to E equivalent upon load resistance plus R equivalent. And now the we will put the value of E equivalent as E and R equivalent as R by N in this expression. So we are having E equivalent as E and R plus R equivalent as R by N. Now taking N as LCM from this, so this N will multiply this E, N times E divided by N times R or plus R. So this is the expression for current flowing through the load in case of n identical cells connected in parallel, and this is I am representing with equation 6. Okay, so we have to derive that condition that where should this parallel combination be used or where this parallel combination is beneficial. As in case of series combination is always preferred when the load resistance is very high as compared to the internal resistances of the cell. But now look, we want to have that condition that where this such type of combination or parallel combination is beneficial. Okay, so here if I put the condition that this small r is very very greater than this nr, means the internal resistance of the cell is far more greater than the n times load resistance. So we can write down here that nr plus small r is roughly equal to small r if this r is having very high value as compared to load resistance. So we can write here I is equal to n e upon r, and this is the value of current which is maximum in case of parallel because it is n times e upon r. E upon R is the current when single battery or cell was deployed. So the current was E upon R, but now if we are using n cells in parallel, current becomes n times, and that is the purpose behind using the combinations of cell. But what if we take this condition that R is very very less than nr? So if R is less than nr, then definitely we will neglect this small r in as compared to nr. So then this expression becomes n e upon nr, and n will cancel out by this n, so e upon r, so I will be e upon r. So is it maximum current? Answer is no. So there is no purpose behind using n cells in parallel if you are getting the same amount of current which was flowing when a single cell was applying. So the purpose is to maximize the current. So the purpose is being served only when this condition is being used, or the parallel combination is used when this condition is basically satisfied. So the condition for using cells in parallel combination is that the internal resistances of the cell must be far greater than the load resistance, and the condition for using series combination of cells is that the internal resistance should be very very less than, or the load resistance should be far more than the internal resistance of the cell. So this is the basic difference between series combination and parallel combination of cells. So I hope this lecture will definitely be very beneficial or helpful in understanding the concept of series and parallel combination of resistances. And if you are having any doubt, you can WhatsApp me at my number
9929391544. You can also comment me on my YouTube channel. So thank you very much for watching this video. Have a great day.